This first photo shows the wheel hub after the car has been raised, the caliper removed, and the brake disc removed as well. Please follow the link provided at the end of this video for additional assistance with all those tasks. Before you even raise the car, you need to remove the center wheel hubcap and loosen the axle nut as indicated by the blue arrow. With a very long breaker bar while the tire is still on the car and the car is on the ground with the car in gear and the parking brake set, attach the breaker bar to the axle nut and remove it. This photo is for the project for the front wheel of bearing on a 996 turbo, but the whole assembly is very similar to the Boxster setup. We're going to be removing the whole wheel bearing assembly and carrier here, so we need to disconnect everything that is connected to it. Disconnect the tie rod from the wheel bearing carrier, insert photo, and also loosen the clamp nut, green arrow, that holds the shock. Disconnect the sway bar drop link. And you can, again, follow the link at the end of this video for assistance with all those tasks. If you didn't loosen up the axle nut while the car was still on the ground, you will need to use an impact tool to remove the nut. Insert photo. The nut is on very tight, and you might have to work at it with the impact wrench in order to get the nut off. Use a high-quality ball joint removal tool, yellow arrow, to separate the ball joint from the wheel bearing carrier. When the joint is loose, use a pry bar, blue arrow, and push the control arm, green arrow, down while lifting up the carrier. Push the control arm out of the way, and then you should be able to slide the carrier off the shock. If you can't get the deflection of the control arm enough, then loosen the bolt at the other end of the control arm, and you should be able to drop it down further. Don't retighten this bolt until the car is back on the ground in its fully weighted position. Remove the wheel speed sensor from the carrier when you have it on your bench. Here's the axle with the carrier removed. Again, this is from a four-wheel drive 996 turbo, so there's a drive axle attached to this particular carrier. This design is very similar to the front and rear Boxster wheel carriers, though. The two section of the axle generates a signal that is read by the wheel speed sensor that is mounted inside the carrier. If your CV joints need attention or your rubber boot is ripped or damaged, then now would be a really good time to replace it. The problem with this car was suspected to lie within the wheel bearing, but we weren't 100% sure. With the carrier out and on the bench, a simple spin of the bearing gave the answer. The bearing was toast. Felt like there was sand or something in the bearing, and its rotation was rough, not smooth. Position the wheel bearing carrier in a hydraulic press and push out the inner hub, the part that the brake disc and wheel attaches to. As it is common with wheel bearing replacements, the bearing itself fell apart and half of it remained attached to the hub. Insert image. You can use a standard bearing puller to remove the remaining wheel bearing off of the hub. The insert photo shows the hub all cleaned up with all the remnants of the old bearing removed. When the hub was removed from the wheel bearing carrier, the bearing split in two parts, one that was stuck on the hub and the remainder that was stuck inside the carrier. We went back to the press to remove the remains of the bearing. Remove the bearing retainer plate first, insert lower right. With the bearing completely pressed out of the carrier, it should look like the insert photo in the lower left. This photo shows the physical damage on the worn out wheel bearing. The blue arrow shows the pitting of the bearing surface. Once this starts in a section of bearing, it tends to continue and get worse. The bearing should be smooth, like the section indicated by the purple arrow. The other half of the bearing is also showing the same deterioration and pitting. Although the seal on the bearing looked intact, this amount of damage leads me to believe that there was some type of contamination issue at play here. Using a hydraulic press, you can easily install the new bearing. New bearings should be kept in the freezer right up until when they are installed in the car. If they are cold, it will make pressing them into the wheel carrier much easier. During installation, press on the outer race of the bearing only. Don't place any force on the inner race, as this can damage the bearing. Install the bearing with the numbers facing towards the wheel hub. Typically, the red-orange seal goes towards the inside of the car. Note the 987s contain a built-in magnetic pulse ring that must be installed facing towards the sensor. Shown here is the wheel bearing carrier from both sides with the new bearing installed and the bearing retainer plate in place. With the new bearing installed in the wheel bearing carrier, it's time to now install the hub back into the inside race of the bearing. This is performed using a wheel bearing installation tool, Blue Arrow, using a circular backing plate that is the same size as the inner race, Yellow Arrow. The tool pushes the hub inwards while compressing on the inner race. Crank down the bearing installation tool until the inside surface of the hub rests against the surface of the inner race of the bearing, Green Arrow. The insert photo in the lower left shows what the backside of the installed bearing hub assembly should look like when the hub is fully installed. Test the hub on the bearing with a few test spins. Don't be alarmed if it doesn't spin too freely. New bearings are generally pretty stiff at first. Reinstall the wheel bearing carrier back onto the car, securing the ball joint, shock tower, sway bar, tie rod, speed sensor connection, brake disc, brake caliper, and anything else you disconnected in the process. Tighten up the axle nut using a brand new nut. With the car back on the ground, use a really big torque wrench to tighten up the axle nut. If you don't have a really big torque wrench, you can use a long breaker bar and your body weight to apply the torque. The torque value for this nut is 340 foot-pounds. So, if you divide 340 by your weight, for example, 200 pounds, you will need to stand on your breaker bar with your full weight 1.7 feet, 1 foot, 8 inches away from the center of the wheel. Do this with the breaker bar perfectly parallel to the floor. It's important to note that you do not always need to remove the wheel bearing carrier for the car in order to remove the wheel bearings. In the case of the four-wheel drive turbo, it was necessary because the axle was inserted inside the carrier, and it was not possible to remove it without removing the carrier. In some cases, you can replace the wheel bearing with the carrier still installed in the car and avoid using the hydraulic press altogether. In this photo, you can see part one of a bench demonstration of the process of pulling out a wheel hub using the tool. Put a backing plate on the inner race and use the tool to pull the hub out of the bearing. The bearing will break apart at this point. Here's part two of the process of pulling the bearing using the tool. With a backing plate placed in the diameter of the outer race on the backside, the tool can simply pull the rest of the bearing out of the bore using the long center screw. Part three of the process involves using the tool to press in the new bearing. Using a really big backing plate that compresses against the back of the aluminum wheel carrier, the front part of the tool compresses the wheel bearing into place. Finally, the installation of the hub into the carrier is performed in the exact same manner as shown in figure 13. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and check out another video in this series.